morning, guys. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. I had a question yesterday from one of those in my community about the earthquakes. I think it was about the earthquakes along the Tennessee-North Carolina border. I could be wrong about that. But anyways, in the news, the only earthquake that was reported locally was this 1.8 that occurred on the 28th. So, and they said it was an intensity level 4, which, is noticeable. 18 people said they did feel this earthquake. And let's zoom in. It was felt over a fairly large area for a 1.8. There it says intensity level 2 and 2. USGS gave it an intensity level of 4, though, which means it would have been felt in that area, maybe a 3 or a 3.5. Felt indoors by many, outdoors by a few. At night, some of them would have been woken up. Dishes, windows, and doors were rattling. Now, for intensity level 2, it says felt by a few people at rest, especially on the upper floors. Delicate suspended objects may sway. And that would have been like an intensity level of magnitude 2. Yeah, very curious when they gave it an intensity level 4. You can see it up here. Anyways, I could only get one monitor for this location, Virginia, North Carolina border region, to work, which was N4 U5-4A. This is the location of that 1.8. And there's the earthquake station. More recently, and it was marked in red, meaning the computer picked it up, but USGS did not report this earthquake. It came in as a magnitude 1.52. And let's pull it down so you can see it there. If you have a larger TV, it says MD 1.52. 1:20 Universal Time. So that would have been at 8:20 a.m. in 45 seconds. Yeah, they're not reporting it. And then there's other small ones here. Let me see if I can find them where they're at. Lots of small ones. I think that might be it. Oh, I want to go back and show you the seismic signature on this one before I go there. And we'll extract that and make it bigger. Yeah, this is all tectonic, basically, in movement. Sharpened points. See how sharp those are? Yeah. So either the fault line moved or the plate moved in this whole area. It's how the mountains were built, because the North America plate being pushed going towards the west. All right, and then we got a whole series of some very small quakes. Before that, the popping. 22:10 looks like they started Universal Time. So that would have been about 5:10 p.m. yesterday. Yeah, there's all kinds of them there. And again, these are also shallow. Some of them are a little bit deeper. And let's... Okay, so that's that line right there. Okay, and looks like we got some more possibly here. Yeah. Yeah, about an hour earlier. Lots of popping. Let me try and extract that. Yeah, see sharpened points and then some wavy lines, which would be slow-moving earthquakes. There's some more right there. A whole bunch there. Look at all that. Like I said, this is the only monitor for that location that could get working. Yeah, see sharpened points. All right, then going back farther, I went back 3 days, I think it was. And then this would have been, the second. Yeah, we got a whole bunch more here that was going on. About the same time, it looks like. Just 24 hours later. And then... Yeah, there was another one. Well, there's quite a few of them. Small quakes. We got one there. And then I noticed there was another one over here. Yeah, lots of popping going on. But that 1.8 is the last earthquake that USGS reported, and that was on the 28th for this location. And I was thinking, well, maybe I misread it or remembered what it was. Maybe it was for the New Madrid fault zone, which is, there's been a lot of earthquakes in that location too. 25 within the last month. Let's see, the most recent, this one right here, a 1.8. That would have been yesterday. Yeah, way up over towards the west. But these are all the New Madrid earthquakes. We got 22. And then if we change it to the last week, let's see, we got 5. The most recent being a 2.0. Greeley, Tennessee. There was also a 1.7. Yeah, up close to the New Madrid fault zone. A 1.8 near Tiptonville, Tennessee. And a 1.8, it just says Missouri. But again, that's up by the New Madrid. I don't think that's what they were asking about, because I've covered the New Madrid earthquakes and, yeah, the activity. And, you know, this is a failed rift system where the United States was originally going to divide, split apart, but it stopped before that. And, yeah, there's still lots of activity, and history can repeat itself, especially with the, core of the earth heating up. You know, and there's an ancient volcano in this area, as you guys know. I did not download the data for this area. I only downloaded it from the one. I probably should take a look at it for Hicks Dome, which is in that area for the volcano. And with all the earthquakes increasing and the volcanic activity and ancient fault zones being reactivated, maybe I should take a look at it later to see what kind of volcanic activity we got going on at Hicks Dome. I've also talked about, as the Earth's magnetic field weakens, getting closer and closer to its reversal. The last time, let me show you this. These are all the time frames when the magnetic pole reversed last time, and it was about 12,000 years ago, and then before that, 24,000, 36, 48, 60, and 72,000. Yeah. And then I got another image. It says magnetic pole drift and weakening of the magnetic field extinctions every 12,000 years. Yeah, there was a bottleneck, as they call it, where humans, caveman, the population really dropped during that time too, and it shows the extinction 12,000 years ago of megafauna, you know, because we went into an ice age. And then 25,000 years ago, let's see if I can make this bigger for you.
I believe Sabertooth.
Anyways, yeah, 12,000 years ago, the woolly mammoth went extinct. You know, what's interesting too, they don't talk about that. They were like instantly frozen, a lot of these species. They were still found with food in their mouths and in their stomachs, so they were grazing when they dropped dead, being instantly frozen. Something to think about for what's coming in the future. So I closed that out. Anyways, yeah, I should look into Hicks Dome and what is occurring there. I do have it on my Google Earth. Let me go over here and show you. So here we have the New Madrid fault system. We got another area of volcanoes. This used to be out in the ocean before, the earth changed so much like it is now. Yeah, it was surrounded by water. Anyways, Hicks Dome is up over here. And another thing that's interesting about some of these recent volcanic eruptions, they've had a mixing of lava from deep lava, from the mantle of the earth coming up and mixing with the magma in the upper calderas of these volcanoes. And when that happens, these volcanoes erupt very quickly. An example, the Hanga Tonga volcano. Once that mixing started, it only took 1 hour for the Hanga Tonga volcano to erupt last year. And there's been two other volcanoes that had the same mixing, which created the eruptions. I can't think of what they are right now. More coffee. Anyways, I hope I covered what that one person was asking about the earthquakes that they have been feeling. I think it was in this location of the monitor that I downloaded. I'm pretty sure it was, but if not, I'm sorry. Anyways, that's all I have for you. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for your questions. If you have more questions, please put them down below. Always be prepared for a disaster. And I will talk to you later. God bless you.